name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Every chain, break every chain.
All sufficient sacrifice, so freely given, such a price bought. I
Kenyan soil.
We need to understand God through Jesus.
There's an army rising up.
And so we will learn together. We will learn some things from you.
Yes.
And you will hopefully learn some things from us, so that we can see the power of Jesus go forward.
Hallelujah.
One of the things that I have seen in my travels around the world is that the Western Church has done very well to bring the gospel sometimes to other places in the world, but we've done poorly in that we not only bring the gospel, but we bring the Western way of doing church and the Western way of doing ministry It takes a lot of money, it takes a lot of education, and those kinds of things. What did they have? They had the message, they had the revelation of who God was in Christ, and that what He has accomplished, and what He does for us, and that now the way that we grow is that God has put Jesus Christ inside of us, a whole new person that has become our identity.
Loves you. You're all very beautiful children, and God says that how much He loves the little children, so you're very special to God. And we come here from America to share God's love with you, and so I just want to enjoy these gifts. There are
for Christ's love, mana upendo wa Kristo compels us. Inatutengeneza. Because we are convinced that one died for all.
Kwa sababu tumeimizwa ya kuwa alikufa kwa ajili yetu.
And therefore all died.
Na hivyo wote wakafa.
So I just wanted to first show that God provided healing. So in Isaiah 53:4-5.
Nataka tushiriki katika uponyo wa Mungu katika kitabu cha Isaiah 45.
Surely He has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem Him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. But He was wounded for our transgressions, He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and with His stripes we are healed. So then, in Matthew,
katika kitabu cha Mathayo
in Matthew 8:16-17
Mathayo 8 ya ndogo 16 hadi 17
this reveals God's interpretation of Isaiah 53.
Inasema jinsi udhihirisho wa Mungu katika uponyaji katika kitabu cha Isaya
53. This reveals that God interprets it as our physical healing, not our spiritual health.
Hiyo inaonyesha katika uponyi wa kimwili sio ile ya harakati ya kiroho.
Jesus never left a person sick that came to him for healing. He always healed them, amen? He never sent them away and said, you don't have enough faith. He never sent them away and said, oh, but you have too much sin in your life. He healed them and then told them, go and sin no more. God heals us by His grace.
Before they came to pray for you,
it was really good.
Uh huh.
Yes.
And now?
Everything went.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 So I'm saying that as you are going, first of all, we met a boy called David, who was a bodaboda man, and he had got some problems. So when you offered a prayer with Brother Robert, in fact, we felt the presence of the Lord. Until now, the boy was surprised. He was touched by the Holy Spirit. Then we also went ahead and we met a mama who was going to the market, and the mama was not able to see well. When we prayed for her, she was now able to jump and the sight was recovered. She was able to see clearly.
Amen.
Then apart from that, we went to another house where we find some young boy with an old mama. So this boy was not able to read. In fact, that thing has been disturbing her since he was born. For him to read, he used to use the gadgets. But when we prayed for him, he was now able to read from far. In fact, he was reading clearly now.
Amen.
Without any problem.
Amen.
And we invited many, many people to attend the conference. They were very much pleased with that one.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
The day was, this lady was blind. I think she had cataracts, and then prayed for her, and then we opened up the Bible. John had a Bible, and he opened the Bible up and told her to read, and she couldn't, it was still a little blurry, and then I prayed again for her, and then she could read it. And another lady that had acid reflux, yeah, in her throat, her chest, so I prayed over that. And then we've seen a lot of people that had hip problems, prayed for, back problems, headaches, prayed with a lady that was paralyzed down to one side, another man that didn't have a leg, so it's pretty cool. And then he got this show of salvation with two young women, and they came to the Lord, so it was a good day.
Okay, it was a busy day. We had to go out, spread the good news for the rest. We met different people with various problems, people with backache, headache, short-sighted, but we saw Jesus doing various miracles and very special. Some people changed their life. The colleagues that we met with various problems, like the backache, the woman we prayed for, she came back and said that she was fine again. And then the another boy that we met when we went to their house, we also prayed for him. He had a short-sighted problem. And then after that, I had to ask him, can you read? And then he was able to read. So we saw Jesus working miracle.
Amen.
We were inside a house praying for grandmother and grandson, granddaughter. And as we prayed for her, actually, I just saw a picture of a sailboat. Wasn't sure what that was. And I thought, well, what is that? And I started to realize the Lord said, is she the sail? And the Lord was like, no, she's the wind blowing the sail. So I just started to pray that over her and then start to explain that. The grandma started to become a little emotional, and she said, that's right, that's what she does. And then she started to tell what this little girl does in the house and in the village, tell
keep
people
praying,
what God's going to do.
Keep praying,
she just keeps telling people to pray, and she's this massive encourager. And I was like, yeah, that's why I saw God comes through her like a breath, and she moves people. And so it was really cool to kind of see some stuff a little bit different, and yet just the presence of the Lord was in the house. It was really awesome to be a part of it.
Amen.
Most of all, the thing that impacted me the most today was to pray for three little kids. When I just prayed and I just said, God blesses you and you are loved by Jesus, and you could just see the Holy Spirit fall on them, and their eyes just kind of just, they closed their eyes and they could feel God go on them. It was cool.
It was just a blessing to be able to be received so welcome, and that they received a prayer. And one lady with, she had stomach problems, and then she had sores in her mouth, and to be able to pray, and she later she would say how she could even swallow again, and she was just really blessed. And the lady with the backache, a lot of headaches, stomach problems, a lady with anxiety. And when you, I was really touched with by laying on hands, and you can actually feel the movement in their bodies, and then they were fine. So it was just a blessing to be a part of that.
Yeah, today was a really good day. We spent the whole day out praying for people. I think we saw these two people receive Jesus just in the times that the people that were named. We also saw a number of people getting healed. in various pains of their body. But one of the things that was special, there was one man that we prayed for at the bus station because he said he had very bad stomach issues. We prayed for him, and he said right then that his pain completely left. So he was very happy about that. But then this afternoon, after lunch, we were out walking in the neighborhoods, and when he was coming into his home, we were right there at the same place on the street, and he saw us and was so excited, and he said, please come into my home. And he had us pray for his brother and also for his daughter, and they were both healed as well. And we were able to share Jesus with them and encourage them, and did many types of stories like that today, but it was just kind of a divine appointment. So that one really stood out to me. Station, the Ministry of Finance, and then a youth place this morning. About 10 o'clock, we broke up into teams and went through the city praying for healing. We saw many, many people get healed this morning, some people get saved. We had lunch, Pastor Peters, then we broke back up, and just walking out of the house trying to get to the place we thought we were going to minister, we kept finding ourselves being encountered by people who wanted healing. So we went to, we were speaking with one young man, and then some other young men came around. Several of them needed healing in their body, so we prayed for them, and they were healed, and they were just completely blown away that this was real. And then some older people came around, and they were coming around just as we were explaining what it meant to be born again. What Jesus did for us is not just for our bodies, but for us to be saved and to be with God, and so that we can have God in our lives every day. And so then the whole group said, yes, this is what we all need. And we all just joined hands, and about five or six people right there prayed to receive Jesus to come into the kingdom. And then we walked a little bit further down the same path, and this drunk man came up to us. And at first, the Kenyan believers weren't too receptive to want to speak to him. But he was saying, I need to be healed. And he had pain in his stomach, so we prayed for his stomach, and his stomach was healed. And then he said, my stomach pain is gone. Now my head is the only what hurts. Prayed for him. And you saw this big smile come across his face. And instantly, he stopped acting drunk and started acting sober. It was amazing. And so we shared Jesus with him. And he said, may I get down on my knees? And he got down on his knees right in the middle of the dirt path and prayed to receive Jesus. And we all got on our knees with him. It was just an amazing thing, and you could just see that the kingdom of God had come. And when we're on our knees with that man, it was like the whole neighborhood was watching. And from that point on, people were just coming to us. We could barely walk and get anywhere. They just saw the kingdom of God invade that place, so it was amazing to...
You get it?
Okay.
So it is nice that we went out for the street ministry, of which we met different of people suffering from different problems, and we saw God was doing miracles on their lives. Some were being healed, and for example, there is a woman whom we approached at first,
but the woman was not able to trust us, so she had some doubt. He was suspicious if he could do a miracle on her life. So beside her, there was also another woman who was also suffering under pain. So she had got some pain on the knees. She also had got some pains over around her neck. And when we offered a prayer to her, the woman was able to confess that she was healed totally. And now she was able to continue with her work normally.
Nilijidharau.
Me, myself, I looked down upon myself.
Lakini nimeona kumbe mimi ni mtu wa maana.
But I've realized that I'm somebody who is more important before God.
Mbarikiwe sana.
Thank you so much.
Asante.
Asante.
Amen. My highlight of the day, one of them was just that our team members that were training were out getting more confidence doing the healings, and there were healings happening by them, and they seemed amazed at it and more confidence. But the one, I guess, that really stands out was a lady, was by a butcher shop or something like that. She had a huge gash in the side of her foot, and it seemed like she just had a problem even just walking on it. She had lots of pain. So we prayed over it several times. I had the team as well as myself pray over it, and she got up and said there's really not a lot of pain. She still had the gash there and everything like that, but the pain was gone and it looked like she was walking on it a little more comfortable.
We met this woman. She said she had problems in her sinuses, and then she had problems all from this shoulder to this shoulder, and then in her knees, and she couldn't walk, so she had to sit to do any work whatsoever. So she just sat there all day. And so we prayed along with Bernard and Brother Bernard and Sister Sister Sarah. And we prayed, and Sister Sarah prayed first, and this heft and her sinuses went away, and then Bernard prayed and her knees got healed and she could jump up and down, and then she says, but there's still pain in this one. And so we prayed and she could feel that one again, and she could move it around, and she was jumping up, and that led to someone else wanting us to pray for them. And it was pretty cool because she wanted peace in her house because there was things that were hard for her, and she struggled with it, and it was relationships with her husband, and he wasn't a very good husband to her and her family, and she wanted a peace in the house. And while we were praying, I felt something move through, and we felt like wind blew past us, but there was no wind. It was, and as like Brother Andy explained to us, he thinks it was that the Bible says that angels go come to us and minister to through by us that through the name of Jesus Christ. And I would believe that might have been an angel or just the Holy Spirit coming in and resting his peace and kingdom on the place.
Alright, today we went out and we got to pray for two guys for salvation. Well, we're getting ready to pray for them, this woman runs up with her baby in her arms, and it looked like the baby was dying. I guess I would say she was probably like 6 or 7 years old, and her eyes were back behind her head, and she was filming from the mouth, and me and Ruth prayed for at least, I'd say 20 minutes, 25 minutes. And
this is so touching that we're ready, getting ready to pray for salvation prayer for some other people, and this woman comes by, their baby, her daughter, and the baby's limp. She's not a little baby, she's a young child, but and she just puts her there to feed, and to see her start to have life. She was limp, just limpless, and to see life come back into her, and her eyes to start to open, but they start to roll, and foam coming out of her mouth, to kind of movement, and then she gets up. She couldn't stand on her own at first, but then she's standing. And she walked all the way to her home. Praise God.
And then they set her on the ground. She sat up. They helped her up, and I helped her get up on her feet. And they walked her back to her house. And kept on praying for her. And then we prayed for the mother. Ruth prayed for her for salvation. And then we just prayed over the house.
This is the time.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This
is, are you Annabelle?
Annabelle. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 Can, do you want to share the testimony?
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I thank the Lord Jesus. I saw the hand of God in this week on Wednesday. I left my home in the morning. I left the two children in the house. When I came around 11, they were asleep. They had had their breakfast in the morning. So when I came back, this one woke up. Then she told me that Angela just took a very little, had a very little tea, but she has been asleep from the time you left. She cannot rise up. So when I went to the house, I tried to walk her. She couldn't walk up. See, her eyes were already closed. I held her by the hand. She could not see. Could open eyes. Her eyes were completely closed. So when I left her alone to stand on her own, then she collapsed and fell down. Then I called her by the name Angela. What has happened to you? Someone has beaten you. She could not talk. There was foam coming from the mouth to her mouth, and the teeth had become, the teeth had at least had come together. Added themselves. Then I called her the second time. Angela, someone beaten you. She could not speak. Forms were coming from her mouth. And the clothes were, eyes were closed. When I tried to open the mouth, now the hands, the teeth had hardened themselves. They could not at least, they could not have a penetration. So I was alone. My husband had died. I became at least stranded. I began weeping in the house. There was nothing that I could do. Then I came out with a child. I was running and shouting and crying. So the place where we live is a place where drunkards are inhabiting the place. When I reach the drunkards, some are telling me that I should board a motorbike. I didn't want to go to an hostel. One of the drunkards were telling me that take that child to those white people to pray for the child. So I was running with the child and arrived at the white people. There were also some black people. Then I put, I threw the child in front of them and I was weeping and crying. They began praying for the child. They prayed with all their hearts. I saw the hand of God. I saw the miracle of God. We went to my house. They prayed for me. And I saw the hand of God. And this child, I thought God always wanted this child. In all those hours, I had nothing in my hands. When I went to work, I was given money that evening. I saw the hand of God. I gave me money and I bought food. We were children. And this is my opportunity. I saw the hand of God. Glory to Jesus. This pastor gave me his number. And I have his number in my phone. I decided to come to this church to say thank you to God. She gave me the reason I came to this church. And I said today, for prayer is not enough for me. The company I've been going is not enough for me. I've come with my children. I told them today, we are coming to say thank you to God. And the child asked me, Mama, are we going to see the white people pray for us? He said that the white people prayed for me. I'm giving you to them. I have decided to love this man, God. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. Today, I'll say this is my church. I've come here. I have come this house with my children. I've been in Catholic. Because many people are there, just to see people. But there is no God that could see them. But I've decided to come to the synagogue. In the power of God, wherever you go. And this is the starting point for making disciples. Because those who are fully trained will be just like their master. Jesus wants you fully trained. And when you are fully trained, you will not live like a pastor. You will live like Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
You will not be like a clergyman making congregations and getting applause. You will live like Jesus, making disciples and advancing the kingdom.
And
this is what we will do this week. Amen?
Amen.
So I encourage you, brothers and sisters, don't go out in the name of your church. Don't go out in the name of a denomination. Kenya is sick of this thing.
Amen.
Kenya is sick of this thing.
Kenya upongitwo badini kitanisani.
God is sick of this.
Yasaibene widoka tuone wachi.
This is about the kingdom.
And what when go on in what piru.
This is about Jesus.
Niwalani mana Yesu.
Amen.
Amen.
So people are used to feeling that you are trying to bring them into your organization. And they feel used. They feel manipulated. And they feel afraid. Don't bring them in. Don't go out with a goal to bring them into your organization. Go out with a goal to bring the kingdom to them. And to bring them into the kingdom. When you love like Jesus loves, they will know this. Jesus was not building an organization. He was making disciples. He was advancing the kingdom. At this conference, we are not only preaching the word, but we are going to say, come and be with us. Let's walk together. And you will see that you can do this
true. We will show you how. What will you say to me? Is that good news? We don't just say this is what you must do. You must do it. But we will help you. They give you the training. So that you have confidence.
What did you say?
How did it go?
No chance.
How many were able to pray for someone?
Jadi mano yung tulo marlamo ng ato.
Amen.
Amen.
How many of you saw the power of God heal someone?
Jadi mo na nakateko man yasay chango nato.
Yeah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 And many people heard the name of Jesus through your lips, even this afternoon.
Jimange.
Many people were able to hear the name of Jesus through your lips.
Jimange yaseko winjo nyingi yaseko kadukum do odia makawo no.
This afternoon. Amen.
Odia makawo.
This was not very difficult, was it? It's very easy. Because even if people do not want church, they do need God. They need Jesus. So if you go to people to bring Jesus, then they are more receptive. Do we have any testimonies that anyone would like to share? I see what I have. Yes. Yes.
I have a testimony to give.
I have a testimony to give.
Our team this afternoon.
Oganda gi kodo dia makawono.
Together with missionary Daniel.
Negin kodo missionary Daniel. Ot mokwongo mane gikwongo donje, ne giyudo nyako mane tuo mane ni kod malaria. Eka ka ne gikawo okang' mar lamo ka gikwedo jachien
mane
e nying Kristo. Eka bang' lamo ne gipenje kaka koro owinjo.
He stated that he is feeling fine.
Eka no wacho ni owinjo maber
edi. He told her to speak the truth.
Eka no kono mono mi wacho ni.
He said that he is feeling fine.
Kendo no wacho ni owinjo maber to kane wakono mono mi wacho ni.
He told her.
Eka no chak gikone.
Who has healed him?
Ni jam mane moseko chagi.
We told her it is Jesus who has healed him, it's not us.
Eka pastor no koni en Jesus maja Nazareth moseko chagi okeno.
Power of God.
En teko man Nyasaye.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Told her that the same Jesus can save you.
They asked her,
do you want to be saved?
Eka negi kwae nitu bende ego momo no mi owari.
She said yes.
Eka no kuni
ye. And we went ahead and prayed for her.
Eka negi kao kambari ye magi lamo ko.
She got saved.
Eka no yudu waro kwa kanyo. Wago ni Nyasaye no kwae nitu bende chako.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. There's another testimony. Praise the Lord, come. Thank you, sister.
Praise God.
Praise
God again.
Amen.
Yeah, we walked.
Negi woto.
And today I've got the courage that I've never had.
Kendo kawuono ne nigi chir moro mane pok nobedo godo.
And they got
healed. Negi lamo ni jomo kuma chuo kutoleo giyudo changa.
We met an old woman somewhere.
Negi romo kodai more bathe kama chini.
Who was diabetic.
Mane negi tumor skari.
And stomach was also swollen.
Kido iye bende kuot.
So we prayed for her.
Negi lamo ne.
And she said she has received the total healing.
Eka no wacho ni oseko yudo changa makene.
We also went to
a
few houses.
We
prayed for people there, some had malaria.
Gilamo ne jiri kene giyudo kane nitie jok moko mane nikod malaria.
Some their children were sick.
Jomoko nyithindgi ne tuo.
And we prayed for them.
Eka ne gilamo ne gi.
And they got the healing.
Eka ne giyudo chang makende.
Thank you.
Isn't our Jesus so good? There's one more, yes?
Tomorrow.
Amen.
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 I also bless the Lord. For what he did for us. We went out with brother Wade,
called brother
Moses, Michael, and Mars.
Moses, Michael, and Mars.
We met a few people. They were not sick, but we prayed for them. Then we came to a certain room where we found a mother suffering from sweat. The temperature is always increased. She had a backbone pain and some pain on her lower abdomen. She had been over bleeding during her periods.
Amen.
Amen. And when she gave it to Jesus, we prayed for her and she received total healing. And she promised to be here.
Amen.
Amen. We have another testimony with us. I will request him to give his own testimony. Because Jesus has done something in his life. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Michael, you can come and testify to the congregation.
Amen.
Amen. Praise Jesus. Amen. When he was with the team he was working with, he left Homa Bay, he's been having high problem. And before we began going, he became open to the group and he told them that he had eye problem. The group together prayed for him. And because he had a problem with when he was walking going, he was not finding it easy to walk. When the group prayed for him for so long,
amen.
God was so much grace upon him and he received bad signs. Amen. Of us, they kind of just like were looking at us like, oh, why are you talking to us? And then we did pray for like blessings over their house and have the Holy Spirit's peace come down, like just to fill their houses. But then we did get to pray for one family who had two kids sick, and the house next door had a woman inside that was calling us to come in because she had. Her temperature, she was always hot, she was always sweating, and she had back pain and stomach pains, and she had other problems that she just had pain, and I think she had bleeding problems also. And I prayed, and I believe his name was Michael. I have to double check on that. We both prayed, and she was instantly healed. She didn't feel any pain, and she didn't feel hot anymore. But then also that the guy that prayed for her, while we were praying for people, he felt confident enough to ask us for prayer. And he's like, I'm having eye problems, and we prayed for him, and the whole team prayed for him. And they each did what they learned from Andy. They all spoke with authority towards the blindness, towards the dimness in his eyes, and he became healed. So that was pretty cool.
It was a good day. I believe the Kenyan team that was with us, they were really receptive of it. Their hearts, I think that's what they really want to do. They were opening up their eyes, and then some of them, the one lady, she prayed for this guy. He had this bloodshot eye. He couldn't see out of it. And I couldn't find anything from the reading. And there was a sign up there. And we prayed the first time, and it was still blurry. And then I told her, put your hand over his hand and then pray. And she prayed, and then he could see. So it was pretty cool. It's nice.
Already, I had a team of three women and two men to take out. Instantly, as we didn't walk far, there's already somebody in need praying for. The one that stands out for me is a house that we went to, a man with ulcers. He is very much in pain. And we prayed two or three times for it, and the pain went away. He was very happy. And as we were leaving, I heard this of a little kid. I said, wait a minute, let's go back in here. And I asked him what was wrong with the kid. The kid had been sick for a little bit, but he was still running around. So I had one of the other team members pray for the little kid, and the little kid was feeling fine when we left. Overall, everybody got a shot at doing the healing, and all that we put hands on were healed. Glory to God.
We went out with a team of five, and first lady we prayed with, she had a mass in her stomach, and immediately the mass shrunk and she was healed, and it was so nice. And then the whole team, it was like our team, just really grouped together then. And I noticed, especially I believe his name is Pastor Ernst, he really was on fire for the Lord and just went out. And the next lady we laid hands on, she had a headache, and that left immediately. And then we kept continuing on, but I did notice the same. The women were a little more quiet and reserved, holding back with prayer, but they were amazed and just continued to see God do his work.
Mm-hmm. Well, we had a really good day. As we walked down, we were mostly Kenyans, and then we had Sylvia with us, and I told them I would pray for the first person that we came to, and I initiated that, prayed. Person was healed. We went a little further. Sylvia saw a little girl laying down on the ground. She was obviously sick. We just about walked past her, just didn't see her in the midst of the kids. And so we prayed. Sylvia prayed. She started feeling a little better. We prayed again. Just hit it. It was awesome. Just started getting the child up. The child feels better. We just moved her on, and it's like you just start to feel the momentum with the whole team. So it was basically really easy to, once we found another person, next person in the team, now you go, and bam, they're healed. So after four or five people, we prayed for five people were healed, and once we came down into town, there's another woman who she was hesitant, and we prayed. I think we prayed for her to become saved, filled with the Spirit. So just a beautiful thing. Then actually people, at that moment in time, you could just tell the energy that we were walking with in faith. It was high. But people were actually coming to us, seeking us out, and they had joint pain. And it was just dropping off, and really an awesome experience. It was just like rolling a ball downhill. Whatever was getting in the way, it was getting crushed. So it was a real cool experience.
One may have a small church that has a dirt floor. Another one might have a large church with a high ceiling and a nice sound system. But I tell you the truth, then each one of us will give an account to God. So it is more important that we are faithful than we are popular. Many men of God make advances by compromising. They are slaves to the opinions of the people that they are, that they serve in their church. I've had conversations with pastors in the United States. They say, I believe what you are telling me. But we cannot have this at my church. The people would not go for it. And I said, who cares what the people go for? If you will not lead them the way that Jesus wants them to go, then you are unworthy. I do not mean that we are harsh and forceful. Have I been harsh and forceful with you? No. I am simply giving to you what the gospel presents. Amen. And this is what the body of Christ needs. If we allow the opinion of people to have the same authority as the Word of God, then we will be like the people that Elijah had to say, how long will you hesitate between two opinions? We hesitate. Jesus says, go preach the gospel. And we say, oh, but maybe they don't want to hear. We say, Jesus says, go and make disciples. And we say, oh, but my church does not want to become disciples. They don't want me to help them become like Jesus. They want to only come and attend. Jesus says, make disciples. And many seminaries have taught us how to make congregations. Instead of equipping people to walk like Jesus, we teach them to sit in our chairs. kazaliti. Instead of teaching them to go,
badala ya kuwafundisha kwamba nendeni mkazalishe wanafunzi wengine.
We say come and sit.
Tunawaambia kwamba njooni tu mkakuje mkahudhurie ibada.
Instead of walk with authority.
Badala ya kutembea na mamlaka
and heal the sick and cast out demons.
Na kuponya wagonjwa na kukemea mapepo.
We say come and sit and listen to me and do what I say.
Tunawaambia kwamba njooni mkatusikize na mfanye chenye tunataka.
Amen.
Amen.
This is a mistake.
Huu ni makosa.
And we have not been taught it so much with words.
Hatujafundishwa sana na neno.
As much as the example that we have seen.
Jinsi na mifano ambayo tumeona.
We tell people from our pulpits, go make disciples.
Tunawaambia watu kwenye madhabahu zetu ya kwamba nendeni mkafanye watu wanafunzi wa Yesu.
But what are we actually teaching people with how we live?
Lakini ukweli ya mambo ni kwamba tunawafundishaje namna sisi tunaishi?
Jesus equipped his disciples to be able to walk just like him.
Yesu alifundisha wanafunzi wake ili watembee jinsi yeye alivyokuwa akitembea.
We sometimes have the mindset that Jesus can heal the sick.
Sasa ningine tunakuwa na akili fulani ya kwamba Yesu anaweza akaponya magonjwa.
Or that a man of God can heal the sick.
Ama watumishi Mungu wanaweza kuponya magonjwa.
But Jesus taught his disciples, you go heal the sick.
Lakini Yesu aliwaambia wanafunzi wake ya kwamba nendeni mkaponye magonjwa.
Amen.
Amen.
But before he sent them out,
na kabla hajawatuma nje,
by themselves he walked with them.
Kabla hajawatuma nje, yeye mwenyewe alitembea nao.
They saw how he did it.
Aliona jinsi alikuwa akifanya.
They could ask him their questions.
Wangeweza kumuuliza maswali.
They could observe his ways.
Wangeweza kuona jinsi anavyotembea.
This is very difficult for people to receive when we are standing only behind a pulpit.
Na hii inaweza kuwa ngumu sisi kama tunawaambia watu ya kwamba waende na wafanye watu wanafunzi wetu, lakini sisi tumebaki kwenye madhabahu.
So I am not seeking to decrease the ministry in the pulpit.
Sio kana kwamba ninayashusha huduma ya madhabahu,
but to increase the ministry outside of the building.
Lakini mimi ninataka ili tuyainue na tuifanye huduma ya nje iwe pana.
We cannot lose this.
Hatuwezi tukapoteza hii.
We must recover disciple making.
Lazima tukaichukue nafasi ya kuzalisha wanafunzi wa Yesu.
This is what we do.
Hivi ndivyo tunafanya.
We go out healing everyone.
Tunaenda nje tukitaka kuponya kila mtu.
We go out blessing everyone.
Tunaenda nje kuyabariki kila mtu.
And sharing the good news of Jesus.
Na kushiriki habari njema ya Yesu.
That the Father is searching for you.
Ya kwamba Baba anakutafuta.
And you have great value to God.
Wewe ni wa thamani mbele za Mungu.
And he wants you in his family.
Na anakuhitaji kwa ufalme wake.
And there will be some who only receive the healing.
Na kutakuwa na wengine ambao wanapokea tu uponyaji,
but some will receive the healing and they will receive us.
Na kuna wengine watapokea uponyaji na watatupokea sisi.
They may say, oh, what church do you go to?
Wataanza kuuliza na wewe unaenda kanisa gani?
They may say, oh, what denomination are you from?
Wataanza kuuliza kwamba na wewe ni wa dini gani ama dini gani?
But when they say this, they are not asking which building shall I go to on Sunday.
Na wakiuliza hivyo hawajamaanisha kwamba ni kanisa gani, jengo gani nitakapoenda siku ya Jumapili.
They're saying, what I find in you, I want more of this.
Ni kana kwamba wanauliza kwamba jambo ambalo nimepata ndani yako ninahitaji mwana wangu. Hiyo ndio ninataka.
Amen.
Amen.
And so those are the people that we come into their lives.
How do we enter my jet? Na kapo ingia ndani ya maisha yao.
This is a big difference.
Huu ni tofauti kubwa.
Because this is the point where the way that we have learned by habit,
na hivyo ndivyo tumejifunza na tabia yetu,
is very different than the way that Jesus showed.
Ni tofauti na njia na kanuni za Yesu anapotuambia.
Jesus was always showing them how to advance and advance and advance.
Yesu kila mara alikuwa akiwaonyesha jinsi wanaweza kuzidi na kuendelea na kuendelea na kuendelea.
He said the kingdom of heaven is like yeast in the bread.
Akasema ya kwamba ufalme wa Mungu ni kama chachu ndani ya mkate.
The one pinch of yeast goes into every single part.
Na chachu tone ya chachu inaingia kwa mkate yote.
mengine yote.
Here's what we do. Hivi ndivyo tunafanya. We find one person who is receptive to us.
Tunapata mtu mmoja ambaye anaitikia injili yetu,
and we do not get involved in their lives.
Na hatuwezi kujihusishwa sana kwa maisha yao,
so that we can equip them to become a laborer and reach their friends.
Ili tupate kuwafundisha na kuwaelimisha ili nao pia wapate kuwafikia marafiki zao.
We don't get involved in their lives so that we can begin to reach all of their friends.
Hatuwezi tukaingia juu ya maisha yao zaidi na ndipo nao
We invite them to come to our church.
Ole. Tunawakaribisha ili ya kwamba wakuje kanisani mwetu.
Oh, yeah. Jesus was ready to harvest a vineyard.
Yesu alikuwa tayari ili apate kuvuna
mzabibu. And we pluck one grape.
Lakini sisi tunachuna matunda kimoja. Ualike nao pia.
This is what happened with Jesus.
Hiyo ndio inafanyika na Yesu.
It says that Peter's mother-in-law was sick with fever.
Wanasema ya kwamba mama mkwe wake wa Petero alikuwa mgonjwa na malaria na homa.
So Jesus rebuked the fever and she was healed.
Na Yesu akakemea homa na akapona.
And she got up and prepared them dinner.
Na akasimama na akamuka na akawatengenezea chakula cha jioni.
And Jesus did not say, "Oh, what this is strange food in your village."
Na Yesu hakusema ya kwamba, "Oh, hii ni chakula gani? Hii ni chakula ambacho sijazoea katika hiki kijiji."
He ate and drank whatever was set before him.
Akakula, akanywa na chenye iliwekwa mbele yao.
Amen.
Amen.
And then it says that night the whole village began gathering at the door.
Amen. Na Biblia inasema ya kwamba usiku huo umati mkubwa kwenye mlango yao.
This was not because Jesus was running around knocking on doors.
Hii sio kana kwamba Yesu alikimbia kwa kila mlango akibisha kwamba njooni niko na mkutano, njooni niko na mkutano.
This is because Jesus had struck the jackpot.
Amen. Ni kumaanisha kwamba kuna mahala Yesu alianza nayo na wengine wakavutwa.
Because Peter was a loud mouth.
Kwa sababu Petero yeye alikuwa anapenda kuongea sana.
Everybody knew Peter.
Kila mmoja alimfahamu Petero. Sio mambo ya maneno.
It's a matter of power.
Ni jambo la nguvu.
kikundi cha washindi wamerejea nyumbani. Amen. Did we see Jesus' victory? Tumeushuhudia ushindi wa Yesu. How many of you were able to pray for some people today? Wangapi ambao waliweza kuombea watu wengine leo hii? Amen. Amen. How many of you were able to see the power of God at work? Wangapi wameshuhudia nguvu ya Mungu ikifanya kazi? Amen. Amen. This is good. So let us take a little bit of time. Kwa hivyo wacha tuchukue muda mfupi. To share our testimonies. Tukapata kushiriki ushuhuda zetu. Of the good things that God has done for us. Kwa ajili ya mambo mema Mungu ametenda kwetu. To encourage our brothers and our sisters. Ili tuhimize wandugu na wadada. Because each of us knows what God will do for one. Kwa sababu kila mmoja wetu anajua kile ambacho Bwana atatenda kwa ajili ya mmoja. He will do for everyone. Atatenda kwa ajili ya kila mmoja. Because God does not play favorites. Kwa sababu Mungu hapendelei. And so the victory of one is the victory of each of us. Kwa hivyo ushindi kwa mtu mmoja ni ushindi kwa watu kwa jumla. Because they are giving testimony to our God. Kwa sababu wanatoa ushuhuda kwa ajili ya Mungu wetu. And our Father. Na Baba yetu. Amen. Amen. This way if someone had a difficult time. Kwa hivyo katika njia hii kama mwingine pengine alikuwa na changamoto na njia ngumu. We can all forget our difficulty. Tunaweza tukasahau ugumu ambao tumeyapitia. Because you were a good soldier. Kwa sababu mlikuwa wanajeshi shupavu. Fighting a good fight. Mkipiga vita vyema. And while you are fighting. Na wakati ambao ulikuwa ukipigana. God is getting the victory. Mungu alikuwa ananyakua ushindi. Amen.
Amen.
So who would like to begin our testimony?
Kwa hivyo ni nani angependa aanze ushuhuda?
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah, briefly, our walk today was blessed so much by the Lord.
Kwa hakika kwenda kwetu imebarikiwa sana na Mungu.
Most of the people we met today.
Wengi wa watu ambao tumekumbana nao leo.
When we were trying to minister to them out in the streets.
Tulipokuwa tunaenda kuhudumia pale mtaani.
They insisted that we step into their houses.
Wakaamua kabisa tuingie nyumbani mwao.
And in that short time we entered several homes.
Na kwa ile dakika fupi tuliingia katika manyumba mengi.
We met a lady here outside here.
Tumekutana na mama mmoja pale.
Welcome us to our house.
Akatukaribisha kwa nyumba.
She received the Lord.
Na akapokea Bwana. Tumekutana na mtu ambaye nimemjua kwa muda mrefu.
I was shocked to see him.
Lakini leo nilikuwa nimeshangaza kumuona.
Grown very thin and too weak to not even walk.
Alikuwa amekonda kabisa kiasi kwamba angetembea.
He wanted prayers.
Alikuwa anatamani maombi.
Then we discovered he was suffering from cancer of the stomach.
Tukagundua kwamba alikuwa anaugua kutokana na ile ugonjwa wa saratani ya tumbo.
The first time he said it was still there.
Tulimwambia mara ya kwanza akasema bado huko.
Say is now experiencing the touch of God.
Mara ya pili akasikia anajihisi nafuu na anasikia uguzo wa Mungu.
We told him it is going to be complete.
Tukamwambia kwamba inaenda kukamilika.
Promise is staying near and he will come to continue to be blessed in the meetings.
Kwa hivyo anakaa karibu na akasema ya kwamba atakuja pengine kwa mkutano.
We went down.
Tukaenda chini.
We met a woman.
Tukakutana na mwanamke.
She was starting the house.
Alikuwa akifanya mambo ya kurekebisha nyumba.
We wanted to pray for her on the road because she came on the road where I was based to another lady.
Tukatamani kumwombea barabarani mahali ambapo tulikuwa tunahudumia mwanamke
mmoja. She insisted that we go to her house.
Akasisitiza kabisa tuingie nyumbani.
Then another man came in the house.
Ndipo mtu mmoja akaja nyumbani.
We were sitting together.
Tukakaa pamoja.
And she told us that she wants her husband to go to church.
Akatamani akasema anatamani mumewe aende kanisani.
But the devil prevented the husband from going to church.
Lakini shetani anamzuilia asiende kanisani.
Lady,
and nikamwambia yule dada,
although you are a believer,
hata kama wewe ni muumini,
and you've been desiring the whole thing,
na umepokisha huko mambo mema,
but you're doing it the wrong way,
lakini unaifanya kwa njia isiyofaa.
You are not to pray again for the husband to go to church.
Kwa hivyo unapotaka mume aende kanisani,
I say that never pray again for your husband to go to church.
Kwa hivyo nikamwambia usiombe kwamba mume wako aende kanisani.
Let's pray for your husband to be the friend of Jesus.
Lakini muombe ili mume awe rafiki wa Yesu.
He has his life in Christ.
Ili maisha yake iwe kwa Yesu.
Then he is going to church will be no obstacle.
Kwa hivyo anapopokea Yesu Kristo kwenda kanisani haitakuwa kizingiti.
Surprisingly enough, when we stood now to pray,
jambo la kushangaza tulipoamka ili tuombe.
I told the
the other person that you also need Jesus?
And
I am the husband the wife was talking about.
So he promised to be changed and he joined me and we came with him to the church. Brian, you can say hi. I also convinced my elder brother. And he also changed and told me, let me join you to the church today. He's there, he's going to say hi.
Here comes a mighty woman of God. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
There are many women of God in this place.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to
play
the name of the Lord
this evening.
We went out with Brother John.
Yeah,
and we saw the hand of God.
We prayed
for a
building
house. There was a mother and a daughter who was
sick.
The mother had a stomachache and the lady had fever, headache, and she was
diarrhea. Ule mama alikuwa anauma tumbo na ule mwingine shida ya tumbo.
We prayed for them and they got in
touch. Na tukawaombea pale na wakaponywa mara tu.
There was a lady who had pain on her neck.
Na kuna mwanamke mmoja aliyekuwa na uchungu katika shingo lake. Na tukamuombea na tukarudia tukamwambia tukarudia mpaka ule uchungu ukanyauka. Na kulikuwa na nyumba tukaingia ambao anasema ya kwamba wakati ambao anatunga mimba ile mimba inabujika.
And we believe that the Lord has healed her.
Na tunaamini katika uhakika ya kwamba Mungu amekwisha ponya. Na anaenda kuona binti.
Praise jina la Bwana lile.
Na barikiwa sana.
Sister Jesus.
Kiufupi.
Yes.
This is the sister that went out with me. And we were almost finished with our time, and I said, "Have you done this before?" And she said, "No, this is my first time."
Na tulipokuwa tunakaribia kumaliza nikamuuliza je, umewahi kufanya hii mambo ya kufanya uinjilisti kabla ya hii? Akasema sijawahi kufanya mara yangu ya kwanza.
And I said, you are behaving like an expert.
Na mimi nikamwambia kwamba wewe umefanya hii kama wewe ni mtu ambao ni mtaalamu.
Of course, yes.
Praise the Lord. We walk together with Pastor Andrew. We had a big group, but we did subdivided and we remained two people. When we remained two people, we got another woman there who was selling some clothes. And then she told us that she was having some pain. In and then Pastor told me that I should touch the bar so that we pray. When we completed the prayer, I asked her, how are you feeling? Then she said that she's feeling okay. And then I asked her to do this. And then she did that, and she even jumped. And after that, we went to the other side, just next to machine there. We found some women there together with one man. After completing prayers, that man said that his husband had a sickness. We went up to the house. We got that lady there. When she tried to go to get up and she was literally sick, she told us that she was really having a stomach problem. Then there is a certain time that she's bleeding seriously. And when I laid my hand on her stomach, we prayed. And after prayer, we asked her, how do you feel now? She said that she is feeling okay. And we asked her to do some exercises. And she got healed in the name of Jesus. May God bless you. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We were a number of people as we were walking.
Tulikuwa watu wanne kwa kikundi tulipokuwa tukitembea.
And we saw the hand of the Lord.
Na tukaona mkono wa Bwana.
And we prayed for many people.
Na tukaombea watu wengi.
And they were healed.
Na wengi wao wakaponywa.
And I want to take two incidences.
Nataka nichukue tukio mbili.
One,
tukio moja.
We prayed for a certain lady.
Tukaombea mama moja.
We had a wound.
Ambao alikuwa pale na kidonda. Kidonda
right leg.
Yani alikuwa katika mkono mguu wake wa kuume.
Prayed with her.
Tukamwombea.
She was feeling a lot of pain.
Alikuwa na jisi uchungu sana.
And when we prayed with her,
tulipoomba na yeye,
now feeling okay.
Alikuwa anajisi vema.
And she could walk around the house.
Na tukamuuliza ya kwamba atembee katika nyumba yake na akatembea.
There is another incident.
Na pia kulikuwa na tukio fulani.
Where we went to a certain lady.
Tukamwendea kwa nyumba ya mama moja.
Who had a baby son.
Ambao alikuwa na kijana wa kiume.
Who fell off and got injured at problem.
Alikuwa amepata ajali akagonga kichwa na akawa na kasoro kwenye ubongo yake. Alikuwa na ile itilafu ya kibongo.
She had lacking money to take the boy to the hospital.
Alikuwa amekosa hela ya kumpeleka mama mtoto hospitali
for medical checkup.
Ili akapata kukaguliwa na madaktari.
We told her to believe in God.
Na tukamwambia kwamba amini kwa Yesu
for the healing,
kwa ajili ya uponyaji.
Pray for the boy.
Tukamwombea yule kijana,
and after prayer,
na baada ya maombi,
the boy was feeling okay.
Na ule kijana akawa anasikia vizuri.
Started loving with us.
Na akaanza kucheka pamoja na sisi. Na katuguza.
We really saw the hand of the Lord.
Na kwa hakika tunaona hiyo kwa.
But in order to manage our time,
lakini ili tukapate kudumisha muda wetu,
we are going to have to stop things here.
Lazima tukomeshe kila kitu pale.
But we are all very encouraged.
Lakini kila mmoja wetu tumeimizika.
And as we eat dinner, we can continue to share the good things that God has done with one another.
Tunapokuwa katika pengine chakula cha jioni, tunaenda kushiriki mambo mema ambayo Mungu ametenda na kila kikundi.
But I am very proud of you.
Lakini mimi nimeshukuru sana kwenu.
I'm very excited to see how you are hearing the word of God.
Nimesisimuka kuona jinsi ambavyo mnasikiliza neno la Mungu.
And putting the word of God into practice.
Na mkiweka neno la Mungu kwenye matendo.
The people that have sent us here will be very excited.
Watu ambao wametutuma hapa wanaenda kusisimuliwa sana.
And we know that we are sowing good seed in good soil.
Na tunajua kwamba tunapanda mbegu njema kwenye udongo ulio na rutuba.
So for this we give Jesus thanks.
Kwa hivyo kwa mambo haya yote tunapeana utukufu kwa Yesu Kristo.
If you want to be part of the lion kingdom, you must have lion life.
Kama unataka uwe katika ile maisha ya simba ama ufalme wa simba, lazima uwe na maisha ya simba.
But when you have the life of God,
na unapokuwa na maisha ya Mungu,
you are part of the kingdom of God.
Wewe ni sehemu ya ufalme wa Mungu.
This is why Jesus said you must be born again.
Ndiposa Yesu akasema ni lazima mkazaliwe mara ya pili.
Or you cannot enter into the kingdom of God.
Ama hamwezi mkaingia katika ufalme wa mbinguni.
Do you remember Mary met him at the garden?
Je, mnajua kwamba Mariamu walipokuwa pale kwenye shamba?
Peter had gone there.
Petero alikuwa pale.
Apostle John had gone there.
Na Yohana alienda.
But Jesus did not reveal himself to them first.
Lakini Yesu hakujidhihirisha kwao kwanza.
The very first person he revealed himself was to Mary.
Ule mwanadamu wa kwanza alijifunua kwake alikuwa ni mwanamke aitwaye Mariamu.
And do you know what he told Mary?
Na unajua alimwambia Mary nini?
He said, Mary, go tell my brethren to meet me in Galilee.
Akamwambia Mariamu ya kwamba enenda uambie wa ndugu zangu tukutane Galilaya.
Tell them that you have seen me alive from the dead. Do you know what those men did? They said, it's just a woman, maybe she's crazy. They didn't take her serious. But I'll tell you what, if they did not listen to the words that she said, if they did not go to Galilee according to the instructions of Jesus through this woman, they would miss meeting Jesus. They would not have seen him. Do you know that where the gospel has spread throughout the world, that oftentimes it is carried by women? And I want you to check your heart right now, brothers, and be honest before God.
Nataka kila moja kwa wakati huu ipeleleze moyo wako. Nataka uwe kweli kabisa na Mungu.
If as I am speaking these things, your heart is beginning to get fearful and insecure.
Ninapoanza kunena mambo haya, alafu moyoni mwako unajisikia kwamba wewe ni mwoga na unakuwa na hofu.
If your heart is feeling threatened by me saying these things,
kama unasikia moyoni mwako ni kana kwamba unasuliwa na unapewa mashaka kwa maneno haya,
then you need to allow the word of God to wash your heart and mind.
Unastahili ukaruhusu neno la Bwana lisafishe moyo wako.
Because the culture of the kingdom is different than the culture of Kenya.
Kwa sababu utamaduni za ufalme wa mbinguni ni tofauti na utamaduni wa Kenya.
I am not bringing the men down.
Mimi sijamleta huyo mtu chini.
But the kingdom lifts the sisters up.
Lakini ufalme ni kuinua hao dada juu.
Because they are daughters of the king.
Kwa sababu hao ni mabinti katika ufalme.
In Christ there is neither male nor female.
E Kristo ukina mabako ukina malicho.
In the book of Acts we see that Philip had 7 daughters who were evangelists.
E bukumati yote kawadole Philip mrene tie kinyiri abinyo manegini kyo yale fili.
One of Paul's greatest co-workers was Priscilla and Aquila. Also Lydia, remember? The book of Romans was carried to the church in Rome by a sister. Named
Phoebe.
This is why I named my daughter Phoebe. Because I want her to carry the word of God. I do not have to push my wife down. For me to be a confident man of God. Because I am a confident man of God, I can lift my wife up. We have gone out into the cities. I have noticed that it's easier for the men to begin to speak with confidence in the name of Jesus. And I have been very happy to see that there have been several sisters also that have begun to speak confidently in the name of Jesus. I have seen people healed in my presence, not through my hands, but through the hands of a Kenyan sister.
Well, I think my highlights from Friday day was probably near the afternoon where Bishop Bismarck shared and you started to realize that the leaders were more than excited. You could really feel a release where they were getting a hold of something that was gonna just keep on permeating down through their body, where they weren't just gonna be even just training what they always thought was leaders, but even their young people, the people that are just carrying the gospel within them. And they, the one statement Bishop Bismarck made was, you know, we haven't allowed our people to do this. And he was just energized by seeing that the people can do this work. Now, we haven't allowed them. And I just felt like I got really excited realizing, they're getting it. And, you know, what a joy to be a part of spreading something like that and, you know, lighting a fire like that. So just that was a highlight for me.
To the pastors, I guess, Bishop Bismarck and Pastor George, they both stood up at two different times and said that we really need to do this. We really need to have this in it. Like, we need to take this and run with it. It's just pretty cool to see that. So,
yeah. You didn't mention my singing.
Oh, your singing was pretty awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, my highlight was, I was getting a little bit of homesick yesterday, and then when Andy started, we started all going worship, and he was playing guitar, it was just the presence of God just fell, and I was just took my focus off of being homesick and just in his presence. It was great. It was really awesome. That's where I was really blessed.
All right, I think the highlight of my day is always the worship and everything like that. Just really get into it, and there's no time limit on it. It's like you don't sit there and say, well, we gotta be done in half an hour. like we do in the United States. One of the greatest things that happened yesterday was the boy with the brain damage from the fall and everything, seeing him walk off and be happy and be able to play again. Glory goes to God, of course, on that one. Amen.
Two highlights, the praise and worship, I'll confirm what John had said, just you just could feel the atmosphere shift and just chains and just things being broken off and the freedom in that all was just fabulous. And then later in the service too, you could just feel the pastors and the leaders and the bishop and everybody coming into such agreement that they want to change the way that they've been teaching the gospel and that they admitted about sometimes being harsh and somewhat condescending in the way they were approaching their teaching instead of the love of Christ, and that they were all going to, you know, work together and you see changing that. And it was just a beautiful, like a ripple effect going out.
Sending us out with authority. Something inside us is coming alive. You're sending us out with authority. You fill us with fire, holy desire. Your spirit is all that we'll ever need. You fill us with fire, holy desire. Your spirit is all that we'll ever need. You are all that we'll ever need. With authority, you fill us with fire, holy desire. Your spirit is all that we'll ever need. You fill us with fire, holy desire. Your spirit is all that we'll ever need. You are all that we'll ever need. You are all that we'll ever need.
Last Sunday, God prayed for me. I was diagnosed with TB, and I could not even walk. I could not even do anything with this hand of mine. But when you prayed for me, when I turned to my house, I just had some pictures in my body, the whole body. I was having some pictures. Now when I tried to call the pastor, I said he could not call. I could not take my phone. When I tried to call her wife, I said she was busy. Now is when I remembered that I was prayed for by a brother in the church. And now I can feel it. And the cold that was getting all over my foot that I could not walk. I'm now okay and I can now walk, I can jump, I'm living, praise to the Lord, and I think I can even walk with this hand of my kids, my God is back.
Amen. Of Jesus' heart.
moving to the rhythm of Jesus' heart. And when we left there, we met another young man. We said that we should at least consider this person. We spoke with him. And he also accepted Christ. That Christ should be the savior of his life. So we also discovered that God is working when we give our life to him. So today we decided we're not going to walk with a white man. We want to walk just black people and see if God can still work with us. Now, if these people still respect our gospel and listen to us and see Christ. And we saw God did it. Amen.
So since my friend, I know he was with me yesterday, I'm going to invite him to first share a testimony from the time that we were out in the afternoon. And since I don't speak Luo, I'm going to invite Brother George to translate so that the Americans can also enjoy.
Amen. Yes,
praise the Lord.
Yes, praise
the Lord.
Oh, I'm going to nya sayero kamano.
I thank God.
Oh, nyoro nye nya sayo miwatuolo mondo wawugi mondo wadua romgi jo moko mapoko mi Kristo.
Yesterday we got the opportunity to go and interact and share with the non-believers.
Banka wanyawa sebe doge megazo kaka wendo sawacho moka duwa nuwa nyewa uwo kendo nyewa diye chiroka.
After lunch we had opportunity to go to the market to interact with the people.
Nyewa uwo to kode.
We went with him.
Kendo nyewa wanage Pastor Peter.
We are with Pastor Peter.
To nyasaye nyomi ya wanguono.
God gave us the grace.
Kanyewa uwo.
When we went.
Wadonje ewa tumoro penkacha.
We entered into a certain house.
Even though
some people wanted maybe to play fall with us, we got some ladies.
Kendo
when we talked and shared with them, they accepted that they welcomed us to pray together with them.
Kendo
after that, we left that place.
So
we entered in a certain house. We found some two ladies. We find another lady.
Ma nene chandro kundingeka.
He had some backache.
Kendo nene chandro kabisa ma gino no kete ma dilo no wuto ge komoro wuto gocha.
She was just walking on crutches.
Eka no nyasaye no konya mino chango.
God healed her.
To nyoro no wacho ni pod en gi lit mano winje e ginene e fuonene gi.
Yesterday she could feel some backache.
To kanyo wuoyo kode japi nyasaye no wacho ne kaka Yesu Kristo ere kendo gombo mondo mi ochang tuone no sane.
When Pastor Annie shared with her that Jesus loves her and that Jesus can heal her there then.
Nyo mewa tuolo.
She gave us the chance.
Mewa lamo na nyasaye.
To pray together with her.
Nyasaye no temo ni maber.
God did a miracle.
Walamo mokuongo.
He prayed fast.
Owacho ni owinyo maber matin.
She said that I'm feeling a little bit fairer.
Wachako lamo nyariri.
He prayed again the second time.
Wachako lamo nyadide.
He prayed again the third time.
Kato owacho ni koro owinyo maber.
Then she agreed that now I've been made whole.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Nyopuonja ni Yesu Kristo.
I learned that Jesus Christ.
Oken mana Yesu manowuotho ndalo mag muma.
It's not only that Jesus walked during the days of the Bible.
Mana kaka muma wacho.
As the Bible records.
E buku mar jo Ibrania.
In the book of Hebrews.
Apar gadeg matendo abor.
From verses 30, chapter 13, verse 8.
Yesu Kristo en nyoro kawuono manyaka chieng'.
Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forevermore.
Koro wanu kane.
So we are here.
Wangini Yesu Kristo pode timo.
We know that Jesus Christ can still do the things he did in the previous time.
Okumana ni kumjayalo.
It's not through the man of God.
Kata mana ina ina kata anana Yesu Kristo tiyo kodwa.
Even you or me, God can still use us.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Nitie neno mang'eny kata wacho mang'e Nyasaye mudo gwedhi man.
I thank you. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor George. Pastor Peter. Yesterday, the first place we went to, the ladies were doing the hair. And one of them had a sore neck. Remember? What happened then?
Praise the Lord.
Yes, Mbake.
Yeah, there was a lady who had a sore neck, the way he said.
Oh, nitie mama moro mana negi ngute kanye let. Kendo nital gimopuot.
We prayed for that lady.
Nye walamo na Nyasaye.
And she tested out if the pain was gone.
No, temo kata no limo ka letno se wuok.
And she was very happy because she was instant healed.
Nyo mora enye nikech Nyasaye no change kanyo gi kanyo.
And whose hands were laid on her neck?
It was Brother Sam.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
And it was Brother Pastor Silas who laid the hands.
Silas
and we saw the Lord doing it. We learned that after
we've
been called,
nyobo punjo rene kanyasaye oseluongowa.
We should not leave the ministry just to the leaders.
Okone go bene wakao tich nyasaye to wakao to wadhuru ne mana jotelo.
But even of us is called and anointed at least to heal and to set captives free.
Yeah. To ngato ka ngato kuomwa oluongi kendo owirgi mondo mi oket ng'ama otwe thuolo kendo mondo mi oyal wach maber ne ng'ama onego yud wach maber.
There was also a nice lesson that I learned when we went to the second house.
Kendo nitie wach moro puonjruok moro mana bedo go sama ne wadhi e ot mar ariyo.
The lady that our brother has testified about.
Mama ma asewacho kawuoyo kuome.
Who was paralyzed and suffered for a long time and was unable to walk.
Mane chal ka gima nigi ng'ol kendo nobedo ndalo mang'eny ka nok onyal wuotho.
We realized that she was desiring two things in her life.
Nye wayudo ni nitie weche moko ariyo mana ogombe ngimane.
One, she desired complete healing.
Wach mokwongo nodwaro mondo mi ochange kabisa.
But besides, she gave us the story of how she has been living.
To moyombo mano no miyo wasigana kaka osebedo bende
kodamo. She separated with the husband.
Negi pogore gi jaode.
And she took the responsibility of raising the children alone.
Kendo en ema osebedo gi thuolo kata gi kinde mar pidho nyithinde.
And according to her words, it's like she also desired some charity or some help.
To kaluwore kaka nyo winjo chal ka gima nogombo mondo Nyasaye oyawne oyude kony moro.
Our brother understood him keenly.
To owadwa nyo winje maber.
But it's like he ignored it for the first instance. But at the end of our prayer, after we prayed, there were three of them and God attached them and even two of them were saved at that time.
So nenitie mina de kanja manyasaye no mulo bang kanyo mina riyo moido waruo.
My brother pretended that she wanted the belt that lady was selling.
Eka owadwa no wacho ni odwaro neno ka misip moro ni kanya majaber ni nodwaro.
He took one.
No kawachiel.
Then he gave that lady 1,000 shillings.
Eka no meyo mama cha shilling alfa chiel.
And he refused at least to be given change.
Eka nyo tamo de mama cha me change.
So see, he said, our brother said something after we had left.
Koro nitie wach moro mano wacho kose wuok.
That is a way of blessing people.
Mane eyo manyalo gwedho ng'ato.
Without them at least taking you just for giving out charity.
Yani mano eyo manyalo gwedho ng'ato ma ok oneno mana ni in tich ne en mana chiwo kony.
And I learned something from there.
Kendo nya puonjora wach moro.
She responded to the need of that lady.
Nyo yie gimiluongo ni dwaro mar mama cha.
But in a wise way that is not showing that we are just giving out money at least for people just at least to believe in us.
Eyo mariek mok nyis ni wamiyo mana ji omuo monde ka giyie kuomwa.
And finally we prayed for a man who had a very big, who had a swollen Shulen Joe.
Ekani tie nyen moro manualamu na Nyasaye mane lebe kano.
And after we have left him,
to banka nwase wuok.
He started to improve and he believed that he would be well completely.
Eka ne wawe kato owacho ne oyie ne Nyasaye dhi change.
Amen.
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 Glory to God.
Would you like to share? Is there something for you?
Yes.
Come brother. Praise the Lord. I thank the Lord. I thank the Lord so much. Yesterday, as we went out,
no one called Sister Ruth.
We were together with Sister Ruth. We really witnessed how the Lord was working. The first thing that I witnessed yesterday in my life, when we make a meeting like this, we may think that people who are here have the burden. But as we went yesterday, as we were walking, some people could see us and they were as if they were a bit mocking us. But some of them had a serious problem. We went to some ladies. When we were trying to speak to them, we got in a certain lady where she was a lot, like she had a problem. She was thinking that she was well, but the child she gave birth to was very thin. When we took our time to pray for the child, we saw a difference that the Lord brought, because as we pray, the Lord will bring a difference. We found another two ladies. When they saw us praying the Lord back there, they were a bit ashamed and they said that we could not pray for them in front of the people. And they took us where in their yard where they were selling some timbers. When we went there, we prayed for them and we spoke to them. One of them had a backache problem. And as he was having that backache, he had also a swollen leg. What I was really amazed of, there is a kind of faith when you have. If somebody just touches your legs or your hands, you just see instantly where it was swollen, it will just shrink and disappear. And I saw God working. And I believe that there is a God that can work instantly. And I'm really appealing to those people who are born again. Believe that there is hospital in you because you are born again by the Lord Jesus Christ. That is my short testimony. God bless you.
I want to bring up Sister Ruth for a moment.
Because
everyone on our team has come from the United States. And throughout the time here, they have led out the teams to go into the marketplace. And here you see us as leaders. But to tell the truth, in America, she sits where you sit. And so, I would like to invite my sister Ruth to share a few of the lessons that she has learned. Especially so that she can encourage our sisters in Christ. And open the eyes of our brothers in Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Yes,
okay. When I left America, I was at the point
I believe the word of God. That we go forth and do miracles in His name. I had not yet ever seen them.
To adiera mara nyasaye manduk ni pok na neno gigo na winje winje kase gana.
I knew being a part of Andy's team.
Na ngeyo ne anachiel kuom mony mar Pastor Andy.
Was part of what the Lord was calling me to do.
Kendo en achiel kuom gima nyasaye ni luonga mondo atim.
I stepped out in faith to join the team.
Eka ne awuok oko e yor yie me abed achiel kuom team no.
But inside, I felt like maybe I'll just be the encourager.
Do chunya maiye na winjo ne anyalo mana bedo jajib.
Amen.
I'll pray and intercede.
Kendo awacho ne apidho kodhi. Alamo.
But I also wanted to be part of Jesus' team.
Amen.
To go forward.
Kendo nagombo mondo abed achiel kuom team mar Yesu Kristo madhi nyime.
Every morning I pray.
Okinyi kokinyi alamo.
And join the team. What I saw as the body of Christ and we come together.
Gima aneno kaka ringire mar Kristo kama kanyakla.
Jesus was working through me to heal.
Yesu ne tiyo kwa kalukuma kendo ochango jomoko.
When you said you spoke about love today, this morning.
Ka ewacho ni niwuoyo kuom gimilungu ne era okinyi makawuono.
In 1 John. It says we love because he first loved us.
E barua mokwongo mar Joanna momo wacho ni wange ni ohero waere nikech en owuon nohero wa mokwongo.
And God doesn't want any of his children hurting.
To Nyasaye ok go mondo nyithinde obed gi gimilo ni midhiro kaachiel kod rem.
So I continue to ask God to take away the flesh that was afraid.
Kendo na alamo Nyasaye mondo ogol gimilungu ni ringruok manigi luoro.
And he continued to help me step out.
Eka Nyasaye nokonya me amako timo ndam.
And now as we lead teams.
Kero koro sane kaka wasebedo ka watelo ne mon kendo wadhi oko.
And I see how Jesus goes from person to person because it's Jesus in us.
Kendo aseneno kaka Yesu Kristo tiyo kokalo kuom ng'ato gi ng'ato nikech en Yesu katiyo kokalo kuomwa.
Encouraging us all, the whole body of Christ.
Eka ojiwo ringruok te mar Kristo.
Amen.
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 So praise the Lord, amen?
Amen.
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 And there was also at least one sister that went out with our team. I'm going to invite that sister please to come and share what she experienced.
Because
as I said yesterday, in America, Sister Ruth sits where you sit. Yet Jesus uses her very greatly. The report that I got from Sister Ruth is that God was also using our sister very greatly.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Yesterday we walked together with Sister Ruth. And many times she insisted that we are the people to pray for the people. The first person we met was a woman who was going to the market. And then she said that she had a swollen leg, and by the time the leg was swollen, and when I was informed by Sister Ruth that I pray for her, I prayed for her twice, and then she said that she was still hearing the pain. And after praying for the third time, and when I prayed, I heard like the bone crack together as if they were joining together. And when I asked her whether she was still in pain, she said that there is no pain. And she was ill instantly. There was another lady that we met. She was saying that she had a bitter heart because of the kind of life that she was living. So we prayed for her, and then when we left, she was full of peace. There was a certain lady then we met. When we met that lady, she said that she had a child that was infected with epilepsy. And when we went there, he had been called that our child had fallen down because of epilepsy. And because she was a saved lady, we prayed together with her. Because he had a lot of fear. And then she said that when we left, she had a lot of courage. And then we informed her that he had power because of our child. And then we informed her that she had the courage and she had the ability to lay a hand so that the child can be healed. There were so many cases we prayed for those people who were inflicted by headaches, and then they were healed, and so many. And then we give glory and honor to our Almighty God because of the work that He did yesterday. May God bless you. Amen.
Before you go, was this the first time that you did something like this?
Yes.
Ma en thulo mokwongo mane time gini owacho ni.
So before you went out, how were you feeling? Were you feeling strong and confident or some nervous? How were you feeling?
Sama kapok nyedhe nyi winjo nade. Nyi winjo ka in gi kiye iye kata luoro moko kata ka dende ne tetni koso nyi winjo nade.
I wasn't scared because at least I attended your training.
You weren't nervous at all?
I wasn't nervous.
You were confident?
Yeah.
No wacho niya, no koni giluro nikech ne osetimo training Migori kocha kendo ne wasedhi kode Migori mo owuotho koro chunye no ken giluro ahinya.
What would you say to any of your sisters who are feeling afraid or nervous?
To ang'o minyalo wacho ne nyaminu moro amora ma iye ka kata nyamiyo moro ka ma owinjo ka chunye nigi luoro kiwacho ne mondo odhi olam gi ng'ato kata odhi owach kod wach Nyasaye?
Anyalo nyisogi ni Nyasaye nyalo tiyo gi ng'ato ang'ata. Nyasaye nyalo kendo gimafwenyo ni seche moko wan mon gi solution mar ngima mar jok moko. To luoro ma seche moko nyalo luori seche moko adhi timo kama to dhi wuok kaka naparo nyalo miyo jogo hinyre to wan mon gi teko.
I can inform them that we have the solution of other people. Sometimes we are being distant by fear, but we should not fear because we have the solution of the people outside there.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's give Jesus a big hand.
Jamani tupati wami Yesu Kristo lwedo maber. Wami Yesu Kristo lwedo maber. Amen.
Upati Yesu.
Praise the Lord. I'm very thankful to the Almighty God in my heart. Yesterday we went out and we went from door to door. Yesterday I was taken in from this place where I did not know where I was going. But I just believe when I understood where we were supposed to be heading to. When we went out, we found a certain woman who was sick. When we greeted her, he started coughing. And then when we asked her the problem that she had, she said that she was coughing, she had a malaria, and she was hearing a pain in her chest. And then we prayed for her. When we prayed for the first time,
winjo maber matin.
She at least improved a bit.
Ochako fuolo matin.
And then she started coughing a bit.
Tuopeje kaka winjo to wacho ni kore ne rame to koro winjo kodhi maber matin.
Then when we asked, then she said that she was feeling pain in the chest and she was now recovering.
Tuochako lemo ne kendo.
And when we did it for the second time,
tuchango gikanyo mopeje wakama waleme.
She was healed instantly and she asked us where we were fellowshipping.
Ne akwanto ne nyasaye.
It was not us, but it was God healing her through us.
Not him, ne ngono gi sano.
And God really gave her the grace instantly.
No, ko gima koro.
And then she was healed. She was healed.
No, kwa jise kama oleme, but kwa jise Yesu.
We never told her the place where we were fellowshipping, but we really showed her Jesus Christ.
No, mom, ne kenya sano, not yoko kalukumwa.
I was very happy because the Lord worked through us. And I am really thankful to the Almighty God. May the Almighty God bless you so much.
Amen.
Excuse me. Was this the first time that you had ever done such a thing?
Ma eno du chinge mo kongo metemo wach mara de kendi wuyo gidi katende mo nege. It was my first time. I had prayed for a certain young child when he was sick in my house. And that young man was
ill.
I never tried it once again. So yesterday was my second day. Thank you.
So does the power of God work through Kenyan women?
Koro openje ni to in sane ka in gi wach minyalo lero. Inyalo lero ni tekre Nyasaye nyalo tiyo kokalo kuom mine ma jo Kenya ka.
Nyasaye nyalo tiyo kokalo kuom ng'ata ng'ata ma e Kenya ka kata ma aloka.
The Lord can use anybody who is coming from Kenya and any other place within this world.
Amen.
Amen.
Sister Lois, is there things that you would like to share?
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is good. Yesterday we went out. There was a certain house we entered which I was so much encouraged. We went to a place where the owner of that house was from a certain religion called Legio. And when we heard, we saw the arrangement, how the pictures were arranged on the wall, I was a bit fearful. Because I knew that sometime he could not allow us to enter in so that we share, because I knew how they were worshipping the Lord. But to my surprise, she welcomed us. And when we entered in, she was a bit quiet. Then we said that we were walking through and praying for people, and then she said that, don't even explain to me because I know the reason why you have come. I was told that you are men or women of God, and you have come in the name of the Lord Jesus. And I see the blood of Jesus is with you. And then she said that the law that you are carrying is a big and a mighty law, a mighty God. And whatever the Almighty God would like to do in my house, just do it and you may live after doing the same. And after asking whether there was somebody who was a bit ailing or sick, she brought to us our grandchild who has been sick for some time. And she said that she was a bit recovering, but there was no strength. When we prayed for that child, we asked her whether she was hearing some strength, and she said that there was no strength.
giye mondo mwacha kwa lamni kendo nikech odowo hi kaka ite.
And when we ask that, that can we pray for you the second time because we want to leave you when you are totally healed.
Tumokumbo naneno kachunye peko wacho ni osebediga kile mwone mangei.
And for the second time she was a bit heavy in the heart because she had been prayed for many times.
Tunaji wataize ni aro onyasai matingo ni madoni mwondo wawei go wadoni mwondo wawei kite finyalo timutije.
And I encouraged her that the Almighty God that we carry, we want to pray for you and we want to leave you when you are absolutely well and you are doing your daily works. And we pray for her for the second time, and she said that she was hearing that the strength was there. And so we really thank God for that. Amen. Amen.
No. Sister Lois went out for the first time yesterday, the day before yesterday. And then yesterday she was the team leader. So we have shown you the pattern. That the first day that she went out with someone who could show her. She gained her confidence. She had the experience to know what to do. And the very next day, we gave her the responsibility to lead her own team. And she sits where you sit. But she will not be sitting any longer. Not only sitting, but also walking and doing the works of Jesus Christ. This is what we have been saved for. So, thank you, Lois. Thank you to each one of you that have taken these steps of faith and courage to obey Jesus Christ, to heal the sick, to cast out demons, and to preach the kingdom. Not in the safety of a church, but out where the people need it. We do it here where everyone believes, so that we can hear the word of God and celebrate together, so that we can be built up on the truth. But then we must do the word. The strong ones can disciple the ones that are coming up behind. And that is, then once they begin to gain their confidence, they can quickly begin to show others. In less than 3 days, a normal Kenyan woman is no longer normal. She is walking in the power of Jesus Christ. And this can happen for anyone. And so those that are leaders in the church must take this as their responsibility and their calling. And quickly you will see that you are able to raise up other leaders. Jesus wants us to be disciples. And he said that when a disciple is fully trained, we will be just like our master. Amen.
Amen.
So I want to challenge you today to walk as sons and daughters of God. To talk as sons and daughters of God.
Nyasaye.
Stop being normal Christians who only sit in plastic chairs.
I urubedo kaka ya Kristo mora moja Kristo arisa. Mubeda bede ekoma plastic.
And then do nothing to help others with the power of God.
Eka imitimo onge kitekre mari Nyasaye mumi isa moro tijini e mana kuoto.
Be a true disciple of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus said that a disciple, when they are fully trained, will be just like his master. But to follow Jesus in this path, to be fully trained, we must start by denying ourselves. We forget about what other people think about us. We forget what we've always thought about us. And we come into agreement with what God says about us. That we are sons and daughters of God. And that we are here to manifest the Son of God. Because this is the gospel. Jesus Christ in you. Strangers that I see that are in need. So I want to challenge you. Every day, stop for one. Stop for at least one. Help, see, minister healing to at least one person. Every day, speak the name of Jesus to at least one person. Every day, out in your marketplace, I'm not talking about your children and the people that are already in the box with you. I'm challenging you to get out of your box. Satan is not waving guns. He's stealing. He's killing. He's destroying. But we have everything that we need to set the prisoners free. Do not sit there in your plastic chairs and do nothing. Stop for at least one every day, and this way you will see your nation change. You will see your own lives. You will see Africa change. To lead us in business with God.
Mondo konywa mondo watim gibi dogo ne ohala gi Nyasaye.
Amen.
Amen. We want to talk to God. Because what the devil is doing is terrible. Sometimes he does it up to your house. And what the devil is doing is what caused our Lord to die. But the heaven is looking towards you. You have been given a weapon so that you may fight the devil. We have stayed and we are in the box together with our children. Instead of destroying the work of the devil, we are just murmuring and speaking and spreading the work of the devil. We want to speak to God. Because what has been taught in the morning? Andy was not here when I was teaching. And what we taught in the morning, he has really taught. Sometimes we take the word of God as normal. Do you believe that you are a soldier? But the Lord has given you all the weapon in your hand. You will be accountable because the reason why you are given the power to the son of power.
Today, we decide to go before the Lord.
When we have been in our heart,
just love being part of this team. It was a highlight of a lot of the things I've done in my life. The team atmosphere was good. It wasn't like I was just with one person, but it was a collection of people. And I've really been blessed. I felt like it was like an equipping intensive. Like, you know, we could go to a seminar for a couple of weeks or a couple of days, and this was like an equipping seminar that was on the streets, come back, debrief on what's going on, and it was a constant work going in your life, over your heart and your mind. But it was intense. It was awesome. I feel like it's kind of raised the water level or lifted things to a different place, that you realize if I relax and I sit down, I guess I could go back to being at the place I was. But I just don't see that happening. I feel an aggressiveness in myself that this is what you were created for. This is what God's people do. They go and they bear fruit. Not that things don't press in on everyday life and you become like the people around you, but it gets embedded in you who you are, and that you are an extension of Christ to export His goodness. And so I look at that as far as what I've taken from this trip, that I've really came up to a different new level of exporting God.
I am saved. I love the Lord so much. This time I want to appreciate the coming of our visitors team from US that was led by Pastor Andy. For the period that they have been here, they've been a big blessing to the church, because their teaching really challenged us. As we were in the church, we were not built in a foundation of going and looking for souls in the streets. But when they came, they insisted that it is the best work of the Lord, of winning souls for Christ. So they started practicing the street ministry, where we were moving with them from one place to another in different streets and even the villages. And we saw God working through our hands that we could not even believe. There is a time that we reached to another mzee that was another old man that was having a problem of a backache. We prayed for him, and then after a short time, we prayed. The first time it was not all that well, and the second time it improved, and then we prayed for the third time. The old man told us that he is now well. We also went to another woman that we prayed for in the market. He was selling some vegetables, and when we talked to her, she told us that she had a child in the house that was not feeling well. And when we went to the house of this lady, we found a young man there that was having a problem of seeing in the eyes. He could not see things near him. And he was telling us that sometimes when he's walking, people mistake him and say that he's assuming people and doesn't want to talk to relatives and even friends when he meets them. But the problem was with the eyes. He could not recognize people very fast. But we prayed to this boy and this man, and then after some long prayer, he told us that now he could see. We tested also, and we moved in a different position, different places. So, and we were telling him or asking him to identify us and even identify the kind of colors that we were putting on and even the things that we were carrying on our hands. So at long last, we realized that he regained his sight and he could now see well. Okay, I also want to talk about my own son. I had a son, and when we were starting the convention, or when we were starting the convention, the first convention in the Migori town, a place called the Suna Junior Academy. So when we were starting this one on Thursday, this meeting on Thursday, the devil attacked my boy of 6 years This boy developed chickenpox. All over the body was swollen with blisters, and he had a lot of pain in the back. That when I was trying to pull him to stand, he could not stand. And the tears were really rolling because of the pain that he had all over the body and especially in the back. When he was to be stood like this, he could tremble. And as he was trembling, he was shedding a lot of tears. So after that, I just prayed for him and left him in the church, in the house. And we went to the church with my other children, my other four children. But he remained alone in the house, but I trusted God for his healing. So we carried out the conference until the conference was over on Saturday. And now when it was reaching on Sunday, I went to church. Pastor Andy preached, we prayed even to the sick. And the people, he called an altar call, and everybody that had a problem came in the church and they prayed. I never came at first. But when I got chance later on, I went to my pastor and told him that I also left my child that was sick in the house. I wanted to believe there so that they pray for me there in front of the church, and I believe so that the healing can go to my son in the house. But Pastor Handy insisted that he wanted to see the boy. So after church, our pastor, Pastor Peter, took them to my house, and they came to my house. They found my child just sleeping on the chair. He could not walk. He was having a lot of pain on the body and the blisters all over. So I was just sitting with him on the house there, in the house there. But when they came, a whole group of six, they came to my house and they started praying to this boy. They could pray for him for the first time, told him to move a bit. He could still feel a little bit of pain. And then Pastor Handy could call him back, just come. And then I was standing in a distance, and Pastor Handy was also sitting on the a distance. So we could test, as they pray, we test if he's gaining some healing. So we prayed severally until he was told to even go out. And he could move out now. He came back again, and Pastor Handy insisted that it is not complete. After the last one, now Pastor Andy prayed, and we prayed, all of us, even Robert, Wade, Sister Ruth, and even Daniel, and even John was there. So we prayed, they prayed, all of them, and then Pastor Handy, and then now I withdrew him from the pastor and I told him to come to me. He came again, and then we told him that, can you now twist your body? Can you feel if you're still feeling that pain in the back? He told us that now he is well. And from there up to now, it is now around 5 days now. He's well, he's playing, even the blisters dried up, only the scars you can see. But he's just playing. Even now I left him in the house, he's just well and praying. But Pastor Andy told us that as he was praying for the last time, he had something coming from him, poop, with that sound. And then the child, now when he came to me, the child was now well. So it was delivered completely, and now is well completely. Even the appetite that was not there, it is now there, and is really disturbing me. In the evening, yesterday, he told me that he wanted to eat chicken and rice. So we looked for that meal, and we made sure that he ate it so well. He's well, he's playing, he's good. I really thank God for that. I really appreciate this group. And I pray that God may give them the energy even to move and enlighten people about this work of God of evangelizing and even looking souls for God. We were just in the church and just welcoming people to come to the church, and we thought that is where our problems could be solved. But I realized that they taught us that our hand is a blessed hand, and it is used for holy work of God, and we can use it everywhere. I was so much encouraged, and the people in the church were also very much encouraged, even to move now outside and pray for those who are sick, pray for those who have the problem, and we believe in them, and we see God working miracles in them. I really thank God for them, even as they are going back. We pray for them that God may give them the energy, give them the mercies, Ajani mercies, until we meet with them again. We really hope that they will come back. We don't want them to go for good. We want them to come back even next year so that they be a blessing to us. Thank you very much. God bless you.
So when you go back, how do you feel? Do you feel like your life's going to be the same or different? Or when, if it's going to be different, how do you feel like it's going to be different?
Well, no, I'm not going to be the same person. I mean, God spoke to me every day here. I shared with you the first night we came here in this motel how God just like strapped me to the bed for 3 hours, just spoke to me. Well, every day he spoke to me, but this here was like, I couldn't move. It's like the Holy Spirit was holding me down. He pinned me down. I thought of, which was it, Jacob? Jacob was wrestling with the angel, and that's what I felt like. And I mean, I'm just going to encourage people, and I, you know, this is, you know, some people always say, you know, mission's not my heart. I said, you know, I'm just going to challenge people, go out, step out, and you'll see, it'll change your life. And I mean, it changed my life, so I'm sure it's going to change your life.
What I enjoyed the most was the fulfilling moments to see that not only were the miracles happening through me, through Christ was doing them through me, but also as we went out with the teams and trained the teams to go about and the miracles that were happening for them. And then as the Kenyans were leading their own teams to see them go out, and then it was spreading and going about, and God's kingdom was just flourishing through the streets of Migori and Masara, and to see how everybody was coming alive to that and just the new life in them. That was beautiful. That was I'll take that home with me and treasure that forever. I feel coming with the team and the team dynamic was, that's what really gave me the strength to step out through that and go about as a team. I did realize in my own strength and in my own might, I wasn't seeing that happen. And as the team came together and we all came together with our devotions and declarations in the morning, prayer and worship, and then we go out and do the streets ministry and the teachings of Andy and how it all worked together to be build up in us the belief that we do have the power and the authority through Jesus Christ, that it is dwelling in us and that we can do these things through Christ. Without that, I didn't have it. There was such a variety of things that we did to speak to the prison system, to the government system, and the street ministry. There was all that variety to step out and do what the Lord had called me to do, and then have the joy of the Lord just uplift the entire rest of the day, and to continue to walk in that and see His miracles happen was, and then the people of Kenya to become on fire with the love of God were my favorite treasures. The hugest lesson that I've learned here is that God's word is true. I've always known it in my mind, but I couldn't always get it from my mind to my heart and really walk it out. And now it's truly alive in me. And not only have I been able to experience that here, but to be able to take that home with me and to share it there. And for myself, I have children and grandchildren to be able to share with that and impact 3 generations. Just right there, and then also just to share with friends and family who, you know, want to hear about it. It's an open door opportunity to be able to share the word of God and what's happened. I know I'm totally different already. I know that God has stripped away a lot of the fear, the confusion, all the things that, as I'd shared with the team at one point, that Lord was telling me that I needed to continue to cease from striving. And I know the word of God says it's not by power, not by might, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. And he put that loudly in my heart, and I kept trying to stop from striving. It was like a habitual habit to, I was going to try harder, try harder. And what he's done is just taken all that away. And I just allow him to work through me. It's not about me. And even as Andy had stressed, sometimes if we're praying for someone and the sickness doesn't leave right away, continue to persevere, and then so many times to see those miracles happen.
brothers from the US, especially the Andy's team that arrived in the country for a 3-week gospel of healing. We went to town. In the streets, we met various people, especially the sick. We prayed for various people, and actually, personally, I can remember several number of people that were healed, but I was caught with this woman who was formerly a teacher when she testified, very elderly, but she could not live, she could not read. So when we were in the street, we met her in the shops. Then we were with Brother John and a team of Kenyans. So when we approached the lady, she could not see, read or see clearly. Then we talked to her briefly, and we said that she could regain sight. And actually, Brother John, who was from the US, offered a prayer. For the first time, he could not read well. Then we tried it again. Then she said, oh, I could read. Then I can remember I took off my Bible and I opened a book. In fact, it was a book of Samuel. Oh, this is Samuel. I was grateful. It was grateful. So when we moved to another street, in another street, we were welcome with that lady. I told her that we are men of God, we are praying for those who are sick. Then actually she was not the one sick, but there was a lady in the house who was sick. So she welcomed the house. Actually the lady was sick. She just delivered some few days ago. The child was crying and the house was full of the noise of a child, and the lady was not able to stand from where she was sleeping in the chair. So by then we had Daniel and Wade and another lady called Mary. So this time around, Pastor John said that we should offer Jane to pray, Mary, sorry, to pray for her. Then we started with the child who was crying at that moment. She would had a pain in the stomach, and actually after the prayer, I was surprised. The child could not now cry. And now the other lady took we pray for the mother who could not even walk up in the bed where she was lying. Then after that, in fact, we left the house when the mother was carrying her newborn. We really saw the hand of God in that place. Now, one of these days when we were in the street, personally in my life, I involved in accidents some months ago, but on the left arm, I was feeling some pain. So I also thought that I could be prayed for, and I called Daniel. Daniel, we could not pray for people, but I'm also hearing my arm. In fact, I cannot do any hard work. Then Daniel offered a prayer for me. For first time, when I twisted, I still had it from hitting the bones. He continued other prayers until I could now move my bones. This thing was totally healed, and even after the street meet, we went to conference. I involved myself in the work of the kitchen, and I had not felt the pain to date. Many other people that we met, in fact, those that were oppressed in mind, we talked to them that Jesus loves them until they even want to know where we are fellowshipping, so that they have Jesus with them. So we brought hope for many, many uncountable people, and therefore, I really thank the ministry of healing. I've been an evangelist, I've been preaching, but the side of healing has not been of good on my hand until our team from the US came and encouraged us. And I've really seen that even my personal hand, apart from preaching, I can lay my hand on the sick and they get healed. So I believe the gospel of healing is real. We have evidence it many places. So I thank the team that come from the US, and I believe that they should be coming. They should have a routine so that we make it a lifestyle, not just
And the only challenge that I encourage and have experienced that we should go because Jesus is with us, that we only fear, but the courage that we get from the encouragement that we have got from our brothers has led me, and now I will not just wait them to come back, but I will go. I will go. Not only within town, you know, what I also experienced that many people, the sick, they are found mostly in the house, especially those who are totally sick. This one day when we were with Brother Andy, we were welcomed in the house where there was an old lady who was just from the previous day from the hospital and could not walk in the street. So I also think that apart from walking the street, we should go to the door to door, especially in the rural areas where maybe people do not even have or finances to go to the health store, to take Jesus to them there, and they believe they will get healed in that place. So, as we are remaining behind, we are looking forward to going to the upper country to take the gospel, or to the door to door, door to door. We meet people there who are sick, who cannot come to them, so who cannot walk in the street. We also tell them that Jesus loves them. The only challenge that I'm foreseeing or that has been experiencing in my life is that, you know, when you plan such like meetings, or it needs some support of brothers, so that you know, cannot go alone, you need to go with others and leave their business, their jobs. So it needs prayers too and support from the believers, those who believe, so that when you are out, they also stand with you in prayers and you see the hand of God outside there. So I'm just but appealing to our new brothers from the US that when they go there, we are not left behind to stay, but we are going to empower many other people. We have seen people that came to conference totally equipped, and some of them or actually believed that they should not detain that thing on their own, but also empower other people. So this thing, in a couple of years, I believe it will be a total change in our way of preaching the gospel. And I can say that there will be a change in the next few years to come. Not only the pastors and evangelists and those who are God, but to have seen the hand of God working with just a mere people who believed and actually put in practice. So as servants of God, we are also relieved in a way, not even burdened, we have to do something, but we equip others, they do that, then we support them in prayers or any other thing, and I believe the word of God in that order we can. So finally, as I'm winding up my testimony, I have a lot, but because of time I cannot express it all. I have the love of our brothers that we have connected with. I can remember from December we had a visitor, in fact our brother Steve from US who came. In fact, he promised us that the team will come. And actually later on we saw that Jennifer with him come from the US who also blessed us. In fact, the ladies were more so blessed. And now we have a team that arrived in August, a team of six. We have seen the hand of God in them, and they have encouraged us. So we are not looking forward not to end it here, but we are looking forward to meet you next time here in Kenya. We also think we can spread the gospel into the US, so we just pray that God willingly we can also take the gospel over there, but more so we want to remain faithful, because as we have come together, sometimes we may not meet with them again, but we encourage them to stick to salvation. Thank you.
I've been thinking about how this has been impacting me. I definitely know I'm more confident, and that, like, even before coming here, there were times where I did approach people, but I was always nervous. I was always unsure, like, how to approach the conversation, how to even start it. And here I was just like, oh, if really all you do is, oh, how are you? My name is this, and I was just coming to pray for you, and we just walking down the street and talking to people and praying for people in the name of Jesus. And I'm like, this is a lot easier than I thought. So I definitely grew in confidence, and I believe I can do it even just back at home. And if I'm walking through the mall or walking through Target or something like that, I can definitely just do it and not even think about it.
I want to thank God for your coming here. I've now learned a lot, the things that I didn't know before, but now I know them. I once was even afraid that I was not saved, but as you came, you taught me the way of salvation, and now I find that I'm also a useful person in the sight of our Lord. So I'm very happy for you are coming here. You have taught me a lot. Yes, you are a very big blessing to my life.
Have you been able to lay hands on the sick?
No, I had never done it before, mm-hmm. but I just did it recently as you came.
Mm-hmm. And can you share a story of something that you have experienced of Jesus using you? Something that you remember?
Yes, I can remember that Jesus is in me, because one day when we went to street ministry, at the time when we were in conference in the afternoon, when we went outside, we went door to door. Then one day we find a lady who was sick, suffering from malaria plus stomach ache. So when we reached there, we asked her to if we can enter her house. Then she agreed. She welcomed us. We were with Daniel. After welcoming us, we asked her if she need any prayer, if she was sick or any problem. Then she said that she was sick, suffering from headache plus malaria. Then the servant of God told me to lay hand on her. Then I laid my hands. Then I prayed, in Jesus' name, all sickness go and live well. And after my prayers, just as simple as that, after my prayers, we asked her if she was all still hearing the sickness. Then she replied that she's hearing just a bit. Then the servant of God told me to lay hands again. So I laid my hand on her again. Then after praying the last prayer, she told me that she was fine. Yeah, after saying that she was fine, so we praised God. And when we wanted to leave, she told us that we cannot live that way. She must have to give us some offerings, because she has seen God. She is now well.
Mm-hmm.
But we told the servant of God, but the servant of God told us that we are being given free, and freely we give.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we don't need any offering. You know, just be with God. So the lady was very happy until she asked us where we worship. Then we told her, yeah, she promised to come. Yeah, that's what I saw. That was, yani, I had never seen before in my life, and I didn't know that I could do that. Yes.
And now that we are leaving Kenya, how do you feel that your life will be different?
Yeah, I feel that my life is different, because you encouraged me in doing that, so I will be doing it. Yeah, I'm feeling just like even doing it at home, when any of my family is sick, I just lay my hands, because I know these hands are of Jesus Christ. I will be doing this for the will of God.
I'm gonna be changed. Excuse me. I'm gonna be changed from this place. Just being here only 3 weeks, is my faith is growing. A lot of the old man has died off here in Kenya. Just working with people and seeing them and seeing how God works through other people. What I'm going to bring back to the United States with me is a stronger faith to build up others and to show them that they can do this work too, no matter what, as long as you believe in the Lord.
So I'd like to say that we have been very grateful to your team for the ministry of the word that you put to us and the training, because quite a number of us have been able to go on the streets and in homes to minister to people, most of them for the very first time. And for the very first time, they witnessed remarkable healings, and at the same time, they were able to lead others to Christ. This was very encouraging to them, and this ignited a fire in them, because for a long time they have seen themselves as just people who can go to church on Sunday and warm the pews. And they didn't believe that God could use them to lead others to Christ or to release healing on people. And so this has been good, this has been very important. And as a pastor, I believe it is very key to for us to bring more people into the kingdom of God. It will not cost us much money. I think yesterday you were in our convention, and it takes quite a lot of money to organize that kind of convention, about $3,000. And that is why we had to start preparing for the convention, which will take place next year in August. So people had to pledge what they will give, and for the next 1 year they will struggle to bring it in bits. I think we will be able to conduct another convention next year. So this is a cheaper way of reaching out to the people and bringing them to the kingdom without any cost. It's very encouraging. And I'm so also was very encouraged with the teachings. I have quite a number of church members have come to me, and they told me that they were challenged, at the same time they were encouraged, and their faith was built up, and they would be happy to see more people from your team coming to visit us. And as a pastor, I was also thinking of having a regular trainings, maybe if you could come up with some kind of training materials to help us conduct regular trainings that we can even do on our own before we have a team. The team will only be coming to supplement, but we can have a regular training on our own. And as a bishop, I can maybe move around in different churches and maybe take 3 or 4 days or even 1 week of training in that particular church, and empower them to reach out in the community, because we have different churches in different parts of the nation, county and neighboring counties. So I believe that only 2 churches were privileged to attend the conference that you held here in Migori, the church in Migori and the neighboring church that is Masara. But many other churches were not reached. So I feel like if we could come out with some training materials that could guide us into training these members, and at the same time taking out, because we attended your conference, we know how to do it, we were able to lead our teams on Saturday and on Friday. There were teams that went out that were led by Africans. They came up with the same testimony. I also led a team and came up with this testimony. One of the ladies that we prayed for that got healed was in the meeting yesterday. She was very happy. So I believe that we are empowered to empower others. This is what is written in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 2. that train men that can also train others, those who are faithful and those who will be committed to the work. And we are ready to become, to commit ourselves to this work. And we believe this is the way the first church, the early church, did it. And this is why, because I asked myself, how was God able to add people to the church daily? This is something we cannot see. But I've seen the cheapest and the simplest way to have people added to the church daily is to get the people of the church equipped and involved in the work of evangelism. They can do it to their own people in their own language and witness the healing and also bring people to Christ. This encourages them and ignites a fire in them. In fact, it's so exciting to see God using you. We have concentrated so much on the pulpit, but time has come that we are going to get down to the people and reach them where they are and bring them into the kingdom. So God bless you very much. Bless those who that we do not know, but that have been supporting you in prayer and also financially to get you here, because I know it's costly to fly all the way from America to this place. So I believe that there are quite a number of people that we do not know that have supported you by praying for you and by supporting you financially. I would like to tell them that their support is not in vain, but it has planted a seed which will germinate and we grow bigger and bigger and help hundreds and thousands of people that they may not know, but the kingdom of God knows, and it is recorded. God bless you.
Munyando, I'm very grateful for what I have witnessed with my eyes, the doings of God. Really, I have learned a lot during the 3 weeks we've been having the team together with us here. And things that the Lord did revealed to us that great help and true help for people who are in need is to go out where they are. We went and found several people. One remarkable testimony was of a lady who came back home and found the child foaming in the mouth, had become paralyzed, unable to talk, just was in a pool of tears. And this lady was also a widow, had just lost a husband. She became helpless, hopeless in life. She was just running the streets, having no money to go to hospital. Then the team that came from US together with us, as we were out in the streets, we reached to this child. The child was thrown into our hands, and we prayed for the child, and we insisted on healing until the Lord raised that child up. We took her by the hand, and we walked up to our home, and we found that the mother was helpless, and there was a great joy as this mother, together with the people, the crowd that are gathered, saw the child talking and playing and instantly receiving the healing. We even decided that this lady should be helped with given some support. Eventually, she came up to the church on a Sunday, and she gave a life, a testimony, and she moved the whole church as she testified on what the Lord did for her. There were many remarkable miracles across the streets. I remember one time when, on the arrival of Pastor Handy, together with the team, we had a launching mission at Masara, where all our churches down the villages came together. And one of us who is one of the pastors who was involved in a road accident in 1997, was coming from Kisumu, a very fatal road accident, and he was now limping as a result of the accident because he had injured his hip. So he was a limping pastor. But when Pastor Handy saw him limping, he called him and he sat him on a chair and realized that one of the legs was shorter by some inches. I am a witness of what I saw. I saw with my eyes the leg increasing by some inches. And the pastor was a living testimony, was very happy, was walking, was praising God. We have in midst of many, many people who came to God, who saw the hand of God, met in the streets. We saw remarkable things that God are doing. And this is the very town where we have been living. We are waiting for people to come to church on Sundays. We've been working much on buildings, working much on instruments, working much on hardware of how to tell people about our church. Even our concern has been just inviting people for church services. But we realize through the ministry of Pastor Andy and the team that Christ has called us to go out in the streets, to meet people where they are, to reach people where they are suffering, where they are in troubles and in pains and are living hopeless lives. So that is what we've been doing for the last 3 weeks. We've gone several places. We've been to churches. Remember one of the Sundays, the team that came from the US went to different churches. One unique thing that has been happening, in every place this team has traveled to, that testimony has been one. God is speaking to the church, is opening the eyes of the church, is taking us to the gospel of the apostles, of the gospel of the church as Christ initiated it. So we thank God for this ministry. Me as an individual, I'm coordinated to many pastors, many ministers, many towns, and also people have been hearing these testimonies and receiving phone calls that remember our towns, remember our cities. We want to listen to this gospel. We want someone to train us. We also want to reach in the streets because we have been feeling at least inadequate to do it, maybe because of the fatigue and so many other things, you know, people rejecting us, the rebellion of people. But God has blessed us. When we started it was very difficult. Going to the streets, we sighed from it. We distanced ourselves. We feel we are very, maybe because of our titles and portfolios and the respect given in the village, that this is a kind of low act that we could not do. But God has spoken with us, and I've seen how this has brought blessings to countless lives. So we thank Pastor Haley. We thank the team that came from the US. We thank the people who are behind this thing. And we thank even the ministry that God has given him, that as this thing happens, may God enlarge it, and may every part of our continent and other parts of the world receive the same blessings. This is a love for Christ, for his church. He seen what the devil has come to mislead us, to teach us on things that are not true doctrine of the gospel, that only Jesus came to make us religious and to make us have attractive churches and also to think of only material things. But this is now going to the poor, going to the needy, going to the sick, doing what the Lord commanded us to go, that go out and heal the sick, go out and raise the dead. This is what we are doing. So we will be doing it with all our hearts because God has done it through our servant of God. We thank him so much. We thank the people who stood with him. We thank everyone who is involved. And we thank him for the work that he's doing here with us. May God bless him and God lift him, and may God make this thing be a blessing in every part of the world. Thank you so much.